So data blending is nothing but I have owned two companies. Means I have something called a superstore market. That is one company. I'm having a superstore, the store market, and same place where I have one more company also, like coffee chain. I have two companies. I'm maintaining one more coffee store and one more I'm maintaining like superstore. I have two companies here. Okay. So now that coffee chain, that particular company data's everything I have stored in a access file. Everything has been records. Everything has been stored in the data source, like access. And here, superstore, everything has been saved in the Excel format. Okay. So now what happens? See, let me show you once here. Let me open the superstore. This is from a different database for a superstore, okay, which I'm having in the Excel file, okay. And I'm here having row order ID, order date, shift mode, customer ID, customer name, segment. For example, whoever ordered something from online, okay. So what is that ID, order date, shift mode, customer ID, everything details has been given here. Okay, so same thing, I have one more data access. So in this access, I'm having actually three tables. One is fact table, location, coffee chain query, and product table. So there are three things here what I'm having, three tables. So this one, location one, area code, state, market, market size, and fact table has profit, margin, sales, COG, total expenses, market, budget, and date, product, area code, is all the details are there. And product table has like product type, product, product ID, and type. Okay, so these are the tables, what I'm having, three tables here. So product, location, and fact table. I have three tables in this place. So now when I want to do visualization, data visualization between these two different type of datas. So where you can see something, there is no common things. So we'll see what are the common things will come. So if I have to do data blending, I should have something common field, or common columns or records to be present in both, either more than one. At least we should have one column which should be same in the Excel one and Access one. So then only data blending will be done. So or else we can't do that, where we should have some same data in both different records. Okay. So now let me open Tableau. Okay, so now let us first import that Excel file, Superstore Excel file. So left side you are having like Microsoft Excel, right? You just click on this. Import that sample Superstore. Just click on. Then
yes,
sir. Done. So now let me drag or let me double click on this order sheet. Wait, let it get query generated. So it has been generated here. Okay. So order ID, order date, ship date, everything's are there here. And keep an eye on this region. Okay. And the state, city. Okay, we are going to do based on that only. And country also, just keep an eye on that. So next, let's go for the sheet view here. Just click on the sheet view. Clear? So now yes, what sir. I'm going to do here, I'm going to take something based on like region. Just let me create one table first of all. Sales and region. I've created a table like this. Okay. So based on the regions, what is the total sales on central, on east, on south, and west? Based on the region, I've taken sales. What is the total sales based on the region? We are going to find out. So this is on the Excel sheet what we have done. And we have something, one more access also. So I want to know there can be any connections between that access file. What is, I want to compare the coffee chain and superstore. Okay, based on region or here, something where I can compare that. For example, on this 2016, if that, what is that sum of sales based on the region or based on the year on superstore. And same thing, what is the sum of sales on the coffee chain? The both thing I want to compare it. I want to make a comparison. Okay. So now what I'm going to do, so I have imported only this one. Okay. Superstore one. So let me click on this add new source, or you can use control D also. Click on add new source data. Add new source data, take access, okay, so then click on the browse button, just browse this sample coffee chain. Done. You have selected, you have browsed.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just let me click on open. So it is getting open now. That's right. So the now query is getting generated. Okay. So we have added one more thing saying that coffee chain. Let me rename this as coffee chain. Okay, on the left side, can you see coffee query chain? So coffee chain query, fact table, location, and product. So let me drag and drop that fact table here on the right side. Okay, just drag and drop on the right side, or just do a double click. So with that fact table, I'm going to add, or I'm going to join other like location. Just double click on this. Just double click on that fact table. Take the location and place next to this fact table like this. Inner join has been created here.
Yes, sir.
Again, next, take the product. Again, make this here. So one more inner join is created. So now I have combined all these.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what has happened from this fact table and from this one and from the product? So which are common, everything has been selected now. Clear. So now go for the sheet view. So now once I imported, can you see here two cylinders are there in the left side?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So one would have been highlighted in, I think, blue color, right? Which is ticked with blue color. The superstore.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now the superstore is ticked on blue color because that is primary one, which I imported first. That is nothing but called as what? Primary one. And this will be considered, the coffee chain will be considered as secondary one. The coffee chain where we have tables, location, product, and fact table, like all these details. And here, superstores, which one we have, like tables, measures, and dimensions. Okay, about superstores. Now we want to find
out. Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me, ma.
I'm not able to link the fact table and location together. I'm getting a error.
Okay. So if you can't able to link the coffee chain and superstore together like this, you're not getting like this.
Not getting it like that.
Okay, okay, not a problem. Okay, let me do it from first. You just watch my steps clearly. Okay. So now let me remove this. Okay. Let me close this coffee chain. I'll be having.
Sir, I don't have Microsoft Access. What to do, sir?
No, you just import it. So for importing also, it is not coming.
No, sir.
What it is telling when you select that and import? What error you are getting?
It's not showing any error. It's not opening at all. It's just stopped there.
Stop that. Once you refresh, right? Because the background is not required at all. Okay. If sometimes in case it may happen, you just refresh it once again, you do it, right? Because you're directly importing, right? Okay. Just try again. If it is not available, means you have to install Access.
Okay.
Okay. So, or else you can try with another data files like CSV or any different files. I'll tell you that how to convert that at the end of the class. How to convert this Excel file having CS, then you can work on that also. So now someone has asked out. So first you are in this screen, ma, you imported this one. Okay, wait, why we want? We will remove off everything. Let me close everything. Don't save. Close everything. Okay, now see here, ma, I clicked on that. Okay, I'm going to click on Microsoft Excel. Then I'm going to select that sample superstore.xlsx. Just select it, open it. So you came to this screen, ma?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So now what I will do, just click, double click on the orders. Just do a double click on orders. Once you went into the orders, once you double click, automatically the data will be loaded. And then you come to sheet one here, where you are in that data sheet view. Now, what you do, just for simple reference, we are going to find based on the region, total sales based on the region. So let me drag and drop the region to the columns and sales to the rows. So we are finding, and let me enable that labels, mark labels, how much I'm getting. So total sales on that region, based on the region, what is the total sales for central, east, south, and west? So now what you do, can you see a plus button under the cylinder here? Can you see this one?
So now? So you got the heading as order samples superstore, no, sir? Under the data. Yeah, but I'm getting only sample superstore, and it's a copy of another, the same Excel which you have sent.
Oh, the so same thing only. Same thing only. So named as to, not
but
a problem.
I'm not getting that orders.
Which one? Yeah, this order, sir.
Yeah, yes, sir.
That is not a problem. That is not a problem. No. Wait. This orders, right? Come to data source. Left side, you come. You double click on the data source. Click on the data source here. In the bottom. Wait,
I will click, sir.
Wait, I will note it. Spotlight enable. So if you do double click on this, you are getting the orders in this place.
It came, sir.
Then you click on the sheet one. If you're getting the tables like this, then you click on the sheet one. Now, from the left side, you drag and drop the region to the columns and drag and drop the sales to the rows. Then you see what you're getting. You're getting a table like this, a chart.
Yes, sir.
You're getting a chart like this, right? Okay. Yes, hold sir. On. So now you just see here. Can you see a tool here? Add a data source. New data source. Just click on this tool. Yes, sir. Just click on this tool. Now we are going to import Access file, Microsoft Access. Just click on that Microsoft Access. So it will be asking for the file name. Just click on the browse. Choose a sample, coffeechain.mdb, Microsoft database, the older file extension. Select that and just click on open. Just click on open. So you're getting one more screen like this. Having coffee chain query. So now what you do, you double click on the fact table. Not on the coffee chain, double click on the fact table. So that's query we don't want it here. Double click on the fact table. So automatically the fact table would have been inserted on the right side here. And then just double click on the fact table. I'll get a box like this.
Yes, sir.
Where we can do joinings. Now drag and drop that location next to the fact table like this, nearly like this, in this much gap. So inner join will be created. Again, same way, next product also like that. You're getting now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, okay. Now, let me come to sheet one. So you can see now two things here. One is order sample superstore, which is having cylinder marked at blue color here, which is enabled, saying that is the primary data for our thing. And here, can you see something? Another one, this one, primary one, where we have category, city, country, customer ID, product, product name, region, all these details here. This is a primary one. And next, you click on the secondary one, fact table plus sample coffee chain. Just click on that. Can you see anything newly in these places? Anything new thing before you have not seen?
Location, yes, product, fact table, sir.
Study budget COGS, budget margin.
Okay. So can you see a small symbol here? Broken link symbol?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is that mentions means? Actually, there is a common, nothing is common between this different data source and this different data source, except state. Only the state is common for both different data sources in this place.
Yeah.
Who's that? Who is that? Ankita, right? Go outside.
No, sir.
Another time, if I heard any sound, I will remove from the group. Okay. So can you see this symbol here? Just yes, click sir. On this. Can you see a symbol, right? Okay. So now what is this symbol meaning is, so the state only is the common field or common column when we compare to the both one. So when I click on this fact on the coffee chain, just click on view data. You see we have added area code. So let come scroll down, just scroll down the right side. See something, we can see something called a state anywhere. Yeah. So here the state is there, right? A column name state is there. When I click on this coffee chain, when you view the data here, select the coffee chain, view the data, you can see something column name called as state. This is a common one. What we have on two different. So in that one and this one, in the access one, in the Excel one, in two different company of data, we have only one common is called as state. So based on that only, we are going to do blending. So that's why I told already, we should have any one common field, so where it will be easy for us doing blending, or else it will be problem. Okay, so first, next go to orders, the primary data. Just click here also. And you can see here in the left side also here itself. Can you see the state? This is the state. The column name which are same. The state. The column name which are same. Which is showing here. In this place. Marking as broken link. Okay. So now what I'm going to do. Based on that, take this sum of, sorry, state one. Instead of region, take this state here and drop it. And let me remove the region and take state from the primary also, from two different places. So you have to take that state from the orders and from the fact chain. So when you drag and drop, you're getting a table like this. See, you're getting a chart like this. So can you see a small cylinder here and which is marked it orange color? What is that represents that orange color? Anyone can tell me what is that represents for orange color?
Sir, does it states that this column, which is state, is common in both the data sets, which is fact table and orders?
Orange color. Difference between this blue and orange. Blue is nothing but primary. Orange is nothing but.
Sir, it's secondary data set.
Okay. So this is from that. Primary and this is from the secondary. So however, we have the common one. Okay. So then we don't have any problem on working this. Okay. Let me remove this now. Okay. So let me drag and drop the region itself from the orders. Come to superstore, take the region and drop on the columns. Remove back from that state. Why? Because we'll see that later, right? Because we have common one. We are working data blending, which is a problem in our data, that one. So take region and drag and drop it again back. Remove of the state, the two states, drag it outside, remove that and take region now. Now that region I've taken, this one is primary or secondary?
Sir, primary.
Very good. So I've taken the region is from the primary, where from here I've taken. So where, let me click on this. Let me search for the region in this place. Okay, light come down. It's very, very important concept. Please concentrate. And the region, south, west, north, east, west, central. These are the regions. So let me close this. Again, click on that sample chain, coffee chain. Let me view the data. Okay. See, there is something called as market, which is common, the same thing, east, central, south, west. Same thing, right? You're getting?
Yes, sir.
But what is the problem, ma? The problem between this and that, the name is different, right? This is named as market and that is named as state. That's it. But inside, we are having the common data only, right? So when we have the data like this, what we can do is directly we can rename that as a market. Sorry, since market as we can rename as what region in the secondary data source. That is the one step, easiest step what we can do. Another step is, see, watch carefully. Click on this worksheet. Sorry. Data. Just click on this data. You are having something called as edit blend relationship. You are having something called as edit blend relationship. It is there. And I click on the data.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what you do, just click on this edit blend data relationship. So can you see orders? Who is that? It is. So now the order sample superstore has been defaulted as a primary data. Can you see here? Primary data source is nothing but called as what? Superstore, order sample superstore. When I click on this arrow mark, if I click like this, the primary will be get changed. Then now primary data is nothing but coffee chai. So let me swap this. Okay. So now the primary data is nothing but superstore. So can you see on this place, for this primary and for this secondary, which is the common one? Both side, state. But we have one more thing, common one, which is this side market and that side what it is named as? What it is named
region.
As? Region. Okay. So now what I will do, I need to add the two here. So just let me click on this custom, click on this add button. So can you see the fields from the primary and from the secondary?
Yes, sir.
From the left side, what we required actually region, right? From the primary data source. On the right side, from the secondary, actually we think we required about market. Am I right? These are two different columns. Has same data but different column names. In primary it has region and secondary it has market. But that source, what is inside the column, the records are same about central, east, west, south, like that one. So now select in the left side region and the right side market. Just click on OK. So now one more has been added, region and market. Now just click on OK. Clicked?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now you can see one more mark. Can you see on that? Coffee chain. One more.
Yes, sir. Broken
chain. Getting here a pin symbol. Yeah. So now what I'm going to do. From this place, I'm going to take sum of sales and drag and drop it. So this is from the primary and this is from the secondary. Okay. In the both different things based on the region we are doing. First, what I will do, I'll drag and drop it here. So this one is based on what cells? Superstore, right? So just let me rename that superstore cells. So it will be easy to remember. Okay, so this is a total cells are based on region under super cells, sorry, superstore cells. And on the coffee chain, scroll down, take the cells, sum of cells, and drag and drop it to here. On the secondary one, which can you see here one? So this is nothing but what one? Cells about? Coffee chain cells. We are getting this one. So now what we are getting? So we have compared, means we are doing blending for different two data from the primary and from secondary, which has secondary here. This is from superstore and this is from the copy chain. Based on the region, we can compare this one. Anyone are not getting this one? Any doubts? So this is how to compare for two different company of database having any one of a common columns using data blending. So this is nothing but called as what? Blending. So let me arrange it ascending order or descending order. So are you in this screen? Anyone are facing any problem on this screen? How to do data blending based on the region and sum of cells for different two database data sources. Anyone have any problem?
Sir?
Yes,
sir. I am able to do that part. Sir, I am able to do that state one, but I am not able to compare the data of region. Actually, I'm stuck in between. I lost my network. That's why.
Okay. So others have any problem?
Sir, I'm just not getting the labelings, like, the amount and above each.
This one, huh?
Yes, sir.
Just you click on this T. This one here.
I tried, sir, but still.
You see, hide, enable. Just click on this okay. T. Automatically, that label will come off. Okay. One more was asking some doubts. Okay. You're not yet reached the screen, ma. Where you got stuck, can you tell me? Once again, can you tell me where you got stuck? Who's that? One more person told, right? Sir, I got stuck somewhere. Where? So about what about others? Everyone are getting this one. You got the result?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. So you are getting clearly understanding, right? Now, what is data blending actually? So even if I'm having different, that is a different coffee up and this is a different something else. But I want to compare the both things, the sales, which is having a high sales and based on west, okay, and east, which is getting high, and central, which one, and south, which one. I'm comparing these two one. Okay, so this is one type of example. So let me do one more example also. Okay, this is finding the total sales based on the region. So finding sum of sales based on region about what? Superstore and coffee. So finding the sum of the sales based on the region and superstore. Now, so let me click on a new sheet, or you can give like Control W. Okay, wait, not Control W. It's for Control W for swapping. Okay, so just click on this one for a new sheet. Control D for duplicating, or you can add it. Just add a new sheet here. Added a new sheet. Now, what is my next question? Find the sum of profit. So let you try this one. Find the sum of profit based on yearly sum of sales based on yearly data. Yearly, okay. This is what for two different ones. So copy sign and so find the sum of profit based on year for both Superstore and Coffee Chai. So just you guide me, how can I do this one? Suggestions, please. What is my question? Sum of profit based on the year. Before we have done the same thing, sum of sales based on region.
Sir, firstly, we'll drag and drop order date.
Order date. Yes, okay, sir. Very good. Order date to the region. Excellent. Next.
Sir, then profit from a measure.
Okay, profit from the measure. Okay, good. Excellent. Then, so this is the primary one, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, for secondary?
Then for the secondary,
okay.
We'll go to profit again and drag and drop to the...
Okay, profit and drag and drop. Okay, can you read this error?
Yes, sir. Fields cannot be used from the fact table plus sample coffee chain data source because there is no relationship to the primary data source. In the data window, switch to the fact plus sample coffee chain data source and click at least one link icon to blend these data sources.
Yes. Okay. There is no something common one they are telling. Okay. So now let me drag and drop it here. So what we have to find out something common. Here we can take something we should see, which is a common one here. We have something called as order of date. And here also we have something called as date. Just the name is different. Nothing. What is the difference? There it is order date and this is here date. So then where we can go and do this one? Where we'll go to create
the data.
Data and then?
Then edit blend relationship.
Edit blend relationship. Excellent. Next.
Then add.
Add. From this then side.
It's order date and from secondary.
Data order date system. Based on what? Order date what? May yearly. Or yearly.
Year.
Year. And the right side secondary. Date. So which is
excuse me, sir. Sir, can you please repeat it again, this step?
Okay, sure. So you're getting C. Let's go for first to that primary data source. Okay, you are told that I have to drag and drop. The question is based on what? Sum of profit based on the year. So sum of profit into sales. Rows, okay. And year based on what? Date, order date. I'm getting this one from the primary one. But from the secondary one, if I go for again, profit, I'm getting the error where I don't have any link to that. So let me drag and drop to here. So I have something the same relation to year, but that is order date and here it is date. So I click on that data. I go for edit blend relationship. Okay, just take on custom and just click on add. On the left side, order date. On order date, we have to do based on what? Year. So that let me take that year. On the right side, I enable the date and let me take the year. So what is the common year on both sides? 2015, right? Now we're getting this one, ma?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now we are creating a relationship between that year order of date and year date. Okay. So for date and order of date, based on year, a link, a relationship has been created. Just click on OK now. Now, can you see this symbol now? Once you created this link relationship?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what you do, drag and drop the profit, sum of profit. Is that clear for you now? So this is where I'm getting for 2011, 2012, 2013, and 2014. And here this side, I have only 2011. So when I click on this symbol here, which extends 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014. Again, if I click on this, one more will be extended based on the months. So on which month, how the data sales has been done, where I can explain that. Again, if I click on this, why? Because this is hierarchy. Hierarchy, just it has grouped all these things together. We will see that. I think we have already done once. We will see that deep of hierarchy also here. And again, click on this. This is based on the date. Okay, so let me minimize the month, quarters, and years. So based on the order date, sum of profits. So this is for primary and this is for secondary. And can you see something, three nulls in this place?
Yes,
okay, so why the three nulls are coming? Totally we have 4 years, in that only one we are getting, another three we are not getting anything. Just click on these three nulls, filter the data, you click, you'll be getting like this. Which one the common one we are having for both the primary and secondary? See, let me go back. Where you'll be getting three nulls here. If you just click on this, you'll be having something called as filter data. Exclude the special values from the view and calculations. So what it will do, it shows you the common, which one from that side and this side. The common years of 2011 from here and here. And let me enable this also. It's just better. Is that clear for here? It comes like this. Is there any doubt still? Based on the quarters, first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, this is the entire one. So now, first I'm getting the profit, sum of profit as a secondary, and next to that I'm getting that primary one. So I want to make it is interchange. I want to make what? Interchange. So then where I can do it like this. Is that clear, ma, until here for everyone? So this is what we have taken, sum of profit based on a year for some superstores and coffee chain. The labels I expect. Any doubt still?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me, ma.
Sir, I'm not getting this quarter order date.
Okay, when you drag and drop that year of date.
Yes, sir.
One second, let me drag off everything. Okay, so now first go for that sample superstore. Take this profit, sum of profit. I'll reset this one. Okay, so take profit sales, sum of profit based on the year only, right? So we have to first link the year. So year comes under year order date, which I'm getting like this.
Yes.
If I go for the secondary one, here I'm getting date here. So let it be like this. You're getting this orange symbol. So can you see a plus symbol here, ma, this place? I'll drag and drop some of profit here also. Can you see here? Here it is coming in the blue color or green color?
Blue color.
So can you see a plus button here?
Yes, sir.
Just click on this. Now you're getting that quarter order?
Yes, sir.
Now you're getting this?
Yes, sir.
So this is nothing but called as how to do that one. Okay. So actually that is nothing but called as what? Discrete. And one more will be having called as continuous. So this is called as discrete and this is called as continuous. Okay. So once you see, if I click here on the year, if I click on this year, so this is discrete and it will become as continuous, where automatically year of date, the color will be changed. See, let me remove that. Order of date. So can you see here, it is there in the blue color. When I minimize like this, which is coming blue color, this is nothing but called as what? Discrete. It is their position. Can you see this line? From this line to this line, this is nothing but called as discrete. Okay. And whatever below from here to there, this is called as continuous. So this is discrete view. When I click here, and if I click on this place continuous, you'll get the data like this. This is discrete. So this is continuous. And this is discrete. Okay, so where the color will get changed automatically. See, it comes like this. And when I click on this, it comes like this. So where swapping. Is that clear? So I'll tell you that in that one more thing, how to do make this one and what is discrete and what is continuous and all. Okay, we will take that one in that hierarchy and deep of filtering. So now when you click on this filter data, where you'll be getting this one. And make it as quarters. Now you are getting this one, ma. Any others have any doubts? Anyone?
No, sir.
No? Okay. So now, what is my another question? Based on the same thing. So it's not like a question. So it's very easy one only. See what? Here first we have secondary. If you switch this to primary. So this side. So it will come as primary. This one first will come off primary. This will come as secondary. So let me take one more sheet. What if I do first secondary as order date and sum of profit? And then if I do the primary one. Okay, so what I'm doing, I've changed the order. Until now, we were doing first for the primary and then we have changed that secondary one. Okay, so now we have done the first one as a secondary and then we are doing this primary one. Okay, so where I'm getting like this. 2010 to 2011 and here where I'm getting 2011 in this place. When I click on this null, which is only one null value. Why? Because when I take the primary one, in primary, the common we have only 2 years. So in the primary, sorry, only one is common, 2011. When we compare it to the secondary, means secondary you are taken as a primary year. And when we compare to this one, here we are having two things, 10 and 11. So why 10 has taken? Why? Because we have only 11. So previous one has been taken here, 10 and 11 from the superstore. And from here, I have taken only 2011. Why? Because in the coffee chain, we have only that particular one. When I click on this null, filter the data, which comes the common value. The same thing. Nothing difference. What is the difference? When I do first the secondary one, and after that, if I do the primary one. So it will come like this. So where if I do ulta, it will be in a different order. Okay, see here, this one and this one. Can you compare this to the sheet two, first which I have taken as a primary and then secondary, and sheet one, which I have taken as first secondary one as a primary and primary as a secondary. For quarter base, let me take it as year based only. This is a difference between this one and this one. Is that clear? Where I'm having two things from starting to end. Means previous one also until where I'm having the connections. That same exact one. If I click on the null, then the same thing will be given like this. So is that clear, ma, now? The three things. Data blending based on the region, based on the year, and in the order of primary and secondary one. Cleared. If I give any other data, you will do right. I know sound is coming.
Yes, sir.
You will do?
Yes, sir. We'll try, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You have to try. So now, I will send some exercise I made it for you. A small file only, not a big one. Just some small, see, 10 KB only. Okay, so this one is for you. Both are in MS Excel only. You have to try blending for these two different Excel files. It means two Excel files that are different. One is coffee chain data blending, one is city sales blending. Okay, so now what I will do, I will drag and drop to the Tableau thing. Just So you have to show me the data blending in this place as same like what we have done currently now, or which is possible there in that particular place. So let me show you once also, and just a glance how and all you can do that one. Coffee, chai. Just I'm not going to do in Tableau. Just I'm going to show you in this Excel. You have to find out which can be a common one, which can be a different one. So which has been opened two Excel files. So can you see here, which is mentioned by name territory, and this side it is mentioned by name of region, and which is mentioned this side state. This side also it is to be mentioned by us. Clear. So the common one and the same common one with a different name. You will do this one. Will you find that sum of
yes.
sales for both? Okay, this is assignment. Find the total office sales or sales profit for the both. So if the values you are getting same means, even you can change the values also while creating the data. I think commonly I given that values. Instead of giving different values, you can change the values from any one table. Okay, like 200, 400, 500, 700, 800, like that. Okay, so now. We have these three sheets. Okay, so you right click and rename it as okay blending region blending or blending regions anything, and you rename this as like yearly based blending, and you rename as order wise blending, and you can save this file for your reference. Or else you just close directly, and you do this as assignment also. You can send this one. You have it saved or you not it saved? Has been saved? Okay. Done, ma. Shall we go for another concept? Is it clear for everyone how to do data blending?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So whenever you work in companies, if they give any type of data which have a different column names, but inside deeply, first thing you have to analyze the data. Everywhere, keep the first point in your mind. You have to analyze this data. What and all we have, how and all we have. Then only we can do it very easier way. Okay, so then it's easy. So now if you want, you can save it or close that and do that as assignment. Okay, if you're done, whatever the done also, you attach in the assignment and send to me. Three sheets.
Sir,
yes,
tell me. The last one I'm not getting as a straight line, like how you have bought it for 2010 and 11.
Okay, like this you're not getting, right?
Yeah.
Okay, you're getting like this.
I actually have 2011, 12, 13 and 14.
So, wait. We're having like this. For this, you will not get like this. You will be getting like this. You're getting like this?
No.
Okay. So let me show you first. First, let me show you. See. So I had a new sheet here. I've taken a new sheet. So basically, we were used to do from the first primary and then we used to do in the secondary. So found I'm going to do first from the secondary one, where I'm making there's a date here. So 10 and 11. And then I'm taking the profit from here. And then I'm going to that primary. So why it happens? See, can you see the blue tick here? For which one I'm getting the blue tick now?
Yes, sir. Now I got
okay. It. So first, if I take this one, so where it comes as a primary and this comes as a secondary. Like this. Simple. Okay.
Yeah, got it.
So from there, yeah. From which one we are taking first, that becomes as a primary. And another one becomes as a secondary. Clear? So just take 5 minutes break. After the break, we will go for another two concepts. Drill down and hierarchies. Hierarchy and drill down. I will pass this recording. Okay, remind me after that.
Okay.
First, if it means before and all, what we used to do in this sheet, we used to take as a primary this one. Because first we are taken from here, so we got this one. And the second sheet, we are taken from this proof superstore, so we got that one as a primary. And the third sheet, we are taking from the coffee chain, where that is coming as a primary. First, from where you are taking that sum of profit and here. The region, the date, okay, that from where we are taking that become as a primary one. If you're taking region from here, that is primary. If I'm taking region from this one first, then that is the primary.
Okay, sir.
Clear? So let me click on the file. Close this. So now let's do with another concept, nothing but called as drill down and hierarchy. We're going to do with drill down and hierarchy. Spelling mistakes will be there. Okay, so now, for doing this particular thing, so check out once whether I have sent anything by name Global Superstore 2006. We are going to do data source. We are going to take like Global Superstore 2006.xl.
No, sir.
I have not sent anyone like that.
No, sir. Okay, so now let me send that. Now I have sent in the group. Okay, so please download it. I hope already we have done about hierarchy, right? Anyone remembers that? Anyone? No one remembers that? Oh, you forgot. Hierarchy, something like what we can do it. Okay, first download it.
Tell me once it is downloaded and opened. What happened? Done? You have to reply right. Once done means.
Done, sir.
Done? Okay. So now what I'm going to do. So have you remember ma what you have done already hierarchy? Have you any idea about that? You have done or not?
Yes, sir. We have done it. Yeah. And we did it for country, state and city.
Same way, you're going to create a hierarchy. Okay. Okay, for based on create a hierarchy for category and subcategory. Based on sum of sales. So take the question and work out. So there it will be easy when we are enter into the company field. However they want, we have to give to them like that. So for that, a proper question will help you to do that one. Done? So now import that Microsoft Excel. Where Global Superstore. Right, it's taking, it's executing the queries. Okay, now opened. Have you opened everyone? Mine's I'm getting late. It is open now. Drag and drop the orders here. And then go to the sheet. Worksheet. Went. So now, just anyone tell me question for my answer. Create hierarchy for category and subcategory based on sum of sales. Anyone? So now what I will do here, take sum of sales and from the top, I'm going to take that category and subcategory. So here it shows the sum of sales based on the category and subcategory where this much is for furniture and office supplies and this is for technologies. Right? Sum of sales based on the category and subcategories. So this is the category. So see here, first one what I'm getting, category. Furniture, office and technology. And I take subcategory here and drag and drop it. I'm getting what? Furniture. What are the subcategories is having? Chairs, furnishings, tables, and appliance art for in that office supplies. And technology has like accessories, copiers, machines, and phones. You're getting this screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I want to create a hierarchy, but what is the problem here? What we have done is actually lengthy method, right? Each and every time we want to drag and drop. I have to drag category and I have to drag a subcategory. This thing has to be done, right? So now what I will do, I'll place it back here. I will drag this and I will drop at that subcategory. So where it creates a category. Saying that all categories. So now if I just drag and drop all categories here, it is enough. So where I'm getting category and nearby that I'll be having a plus button. When I click on this, automatically create. So which reduces my work and which simplifies that how we have to extract the data. Clear? So now this is based on category and subcategory, which is very small what I showed you. So now the same thing you tell me. Based on timeline. I want based on timeline. So which we will take here. Let me cancel all this. This one is clear. You're getting this screen now. First confirm me that. This is a very small hierarchy what I have created. So now I'll clear this and I'll delete this hierarchy also where I do right click on that hierarchy and remove this hierarchy. So now the question is what? Create a hierarchy based on the timeline. How you will do this one, Mark? Anyone?
So date.
Yes. Date where? Date. Okay. Where is the date? Yeah, order it is here. Okay. Date, then mark. What and all can be created?
Sir, ship date.
Okay, order date is there. That is ship date. Okay. Order date. And then, so first what we will do, let's take that profit. And we will see what happens here. Order date we will take. What happens? Automatically you are getting. Why? Because the order date contains years, quarters, month, and day. So let me minus everything. So this is a report which is done based on sum of sales based on the yearly report. It's a yearly report. Okay. So let me enable that label. This is what yearly report. So now I want to see that based on the quarter wise. Where I can show them is a quarter wise. And where I can show them as this one like this. month wise, and where I can show them this as a order per date, day wise, and which dates how much. So where like this, on which date, what is the date, like this. But what I wanted, so I'm feeling something where I don't want to do like this. So this is actually called as what? What is this I told? This place. So let's first let me minimize and which I added. So this one, which I'm having this in the blue color, which I've taken from where? Discrete, right? Okay. So what I will do, I don't want like this varying hierarchy. I don't want like adding hierarchy like this. So what time, just click on this arrow mark, come down, make it as continuous based on the year. 2, 3, 4. And then just click on this, make on quarters. So where I'm not getting extra. If I do plus also, next orders. If I do plus also, I will not get anything. See, I'm doing based on this one here. When I click on plus button, where I'm not getting any next one. And once see, if I'm in the discrete, what is the color? If I use discrete, I'm getting. When I'm use discrete, what color I'm getting?
Blue.
Blue. And if I click expand, it is keep on going expanding like this, extracting the data. Okay. And if I make this to continuous, and I select this one here, so automatically the color will be changed to green, where it says continues. When the color will get changed, and I select that continues, the color will get changed. And even you will be having the plus button here, but it will not get extracted. Means it will not go next like that. When I click from here to next, what? Quarters. After quarters, next what will be there? After quarter, what is the next one, ma?
Month.
Very good. Month. And next month?
Days.
Weeks, and then days. So see, very easy. And I say in week wise, how easily I can represent the data to them. See, week wise, and when I can show them also when it is March 11th, 2012 sales about. So which is high here is about November 15th, 2015 about sales about this much. And if I go for day, where I think nearly this is the high one, order of the date is November 18th, 2015, where I done sales about 39,536. Easiest way of representing. So it's just as a date. So you clear about what is discrete?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Discrete and continuous. This is what? Discrete and continuous. The same thing. Come to the left side. So we are going to create something, a hierarchy, based on date. Something is there, okay. Region, city. So location, we will create something location. See, for example, can you see here something called as region? So drag and drop that region under that country and let it make that as location. And drag and drop that city also under this one. And anything else we can drag and drop inside that? Even state. So when I take this location and I drag and drop, so automatically I'll get like this. Just a minute, ma. I'll be back. Just a minute. See here. So now what I will do here, I can click on the country and I can choose whichever you want. One second. Data view. So I will take off that order date. Wait, it is taking time to review that. I'll remove off this one. See, country, city, and state. So how this is what happens. And then when I want to remove this, just I can click here. I can remove from this place also, or else I can just drag and drop it outside also. Okay. So my system became very slow. So where I dragged and dropped outside, only this much I'm having, and I can take this any other data like this. Clear? Is that clear for everyone, this one? How to make hierarchy? And then what I will do in the left side, the place where I'm having all these things, and just click here on the arrow mark, which is there here, and you can remove that hierarchy. And then what I can do one more thing here also, just I will do right click here. I do a right click here, create, it's empty place, not empty place, group by folders, and then where I can do right click and I can create a folder also. Okay. For that first thing, we can right click here. See here, just click on this place and the arrow mark which is there here, and just click on group by folders. Okay, so can you see an empty area? It is getting filled. Can you see an empty area in this bottom here anywhere? Can you see any area, ma? Or just click on right click. Go for folders, create a folder. Folder name is nothing but called as locations. Okay, I'm going to add country to this one and postal code to this one and state to this one. So see now where it will be very easy for me to identify. So where separate locations, separate IDs are separate, like IDs means customer ID, order ID, delivery ID, product ID, and one more group let me create. Right click, create a folder. Okay, IDs. Under IDs, I'll drag and drop order ID, custom ID, row ID, so now tell me what is the use of the making like this as a folder? What is the use of this, ma?
Sir, it will save the time. We don't have to drag and drop again and again.
Yes, it saves our time. We no need to search each and every time, and you don't have to drag and drop again. So where easily we can create folders, and we are grouping it, keeping it one type of item separate will help us to do fast searching. IDs means just open the folder. See, like this, you're taking IDs, just expand the folder of IDs and take which ID you want. Location, take which type of location you want, or take drag and drag like this. So far you have to create hierarchy first for this, then only. And if you want to rename the folders, we can rename, and if you want to remove the folders, you can remove the folders also. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what you have done previously, you have done order date. For that order date, you have done sum of sales profit. And we have done all these things. What is discrete and what is continuous? Okay. These all things. And we are done here. See, we can have like week numbers in the most custom. Only I want values about months, only about months. And again, click here. I can go for customs. However, want you can do it. Month, day, yes, same thing. So these are all the things what we can do based on this. Drill down data. Drill down is nothing but how we are drilling down and we are submitting the data for them. This is what drill down actually. How we are drilled down. See, I'm drilling down, drill. This is what drilling actually. I'm deep, I'm going deep, deep. Drilling down means this much low level, how I'm going to show them the data. This is nothing but called as drill down. And hierarchy means what we have done the left side. Is that clear? Drill down is nothing but what we are creating. This like this, inside that, how we can continuous and discrete. It's nothing but called as drill down. And this one is called as hierarchy. And next one, we are going to see table calculations. So next we are going to see what? Table calculations. So now for this table calculations, let us take what Superstore 2016, the same workbook. So for that, I'll just click on this, reset everything, close off the sheet, and also I'll reset everything and close it. Remove the folder. And I remove the folder. Okay, let me reset it. Yeah, it's fine now. So have you taken, cleared and taken new sheet or import it once? Once again, you can take a new source again. You can import that. Take source data is nothing but Global Superstore 2016. Taken? Done, ma? So fast, little fast. We have another 2 minutes. We'll finish up some concept on that. Okay, good. Who is this source data? Who has written this one?
Sorry, sir.
So now what I will do, let me give a question. So create sum of sales based on the category is my first question. My first question is what? Create sum of sales by category. So the question continues. So then I'll tell you how it continues, what you have to do. I will ask the question. So now first, show me how you can do. Sum of sales by category.
So firstly, drag and drop category into the sheet and then sales.
Category, where it is category, can't able to see that. Ah, sorry. And then?
Sales. And then sales.
Okay, so it is coming like this. Let me swap down this. It will be better, I think. Create a chart like this. Is it okay? Let it come like this. Let it be like this. Okay. So now let me reflect this with the bar chart. Let me click on this, take the bar chart, and I'll show this bar chart like this. Sum of sales. Think about here. And I make that label and I make bar chart here. I can share. Yeah. Swap this like this. So now I have enabled what is the sales of that furniture total amount. And I've enabled supplies, office supplies, how much. And I have enabled technology for how much. But what I wanted is now, I don't want what is the amount. I want to know the calculations like percentage, for how much percentage furnaces has been done, for how much percentage office supplies has been done, sales of office supplies and sales of furnitures and sales of technologies. I want to show in the percentage. I want don't want in that number sales like this. Okay, so then how can I make this one? It's nothing but see, drag and drop sum of sales in this place. Just click this, drag sum of sales here on the details. And just click on the down arrow mark. Can you see something called as quick table calculations? Can you see something called as quick table calculation, Ma?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So just click on this, select percentage differences. Percentage of total. And then actually, you should do this for this one. Percent of total. Sorry, don't do it here. Do it there. I will clear the tabular calculations from this place. Okay, I'm doing in this place. Just click here. Go for quick table calculation. Percent of total. So, furnitures has been done for how much? 32.513%. And office supplies has been done for 29.958. And technology has been done for how much? For how much, Ma?
37.529.
Yes, I'm checking that you're there or not. But I don't know how many people are you there. Okay, let's take a small attendance. Okay, wait. Ankita? Absent.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Afsan. Absent.
Yes, sir. No, sir. I'm there.
There. You only tell me your name, Ma. Srivastava.
Sir, Akanksha Srivastava.
Akanksha. Okay. Present. Ananya. Absent. Raj Singh, Ayushi Raj Singh, absent. Bhavana,
present, sir.
Present. CK Vinita,
present, sir.
Lydia,
present, sir.
Maddie Jayasri, you're there, Jayasri. Absent. Muskan Khaba, I think that's the name. I pronounce this right. You are there? No. Neha, Lubuna.
Present, sir. I'm there, sir.
Yeah, you are there two times. But I will not give two attendance for you. Okay. Palak.
Okay, sir.
Present, sir.
Rohi or Ruhi? Absent. So, see how many people are there attending, but they're not listening to the class. Right? It is boring, such type of boring, huh? So much boring is the class is boring. Why this many?
No, sir.
Then why?
No, sir.
They're just logged in and there's roaming sync. Okay.
So can you please repeat it again? How to get in percentage? Actually, I'm not so able to do that.
Who is that coming now? I'm saying my attendance. Who is this?
Sakshi Singhvi. You did not. Sir Sakshi Singhvi. Okay, I was there only.
I have not called your name, huh?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, you are present now. Okay, so your doubt is nothing but, wait, I'll drag and drop it back here. Take category I've taken. Taken sales, sum of sales here. You are there in this screen?
Yes, sir.
Now just click on this arrow mark, which is on the rows. Just click on this arrow mark. Go for pick table calculations.
Yes, sir. Got it.
Yeah. So just take percent of total.
Yes, sir.
Now I've taken this one, right? Now what we are going to do, the next one is nothing but, so go for this analyze, go for, sorry, wait, not for analyze. Yeah, analyze only, but here the tools is not visible. Yeah. So just click on this analyze, go for the totals. Can you see something called as show row grand total, show column grand total, show totals at top? Can you see this one? So actually what I wanted, show total grand total. So out of 100 this much. So actually in this place, it will not work properly. Let me remove this here. Okay. So we will do the same thing for another place, which a different data, which we can use this one there. Okay. So next question is, calculate the percentage of sales done by category and subcategory. So how can I make changes here?
So you can make the hierarchy, or you can drag the subcategory.
That's it. Over, right? Very simple. So can you see this 11%, 11%, 3%, and 5.9%? So all this what we are getting. So now what I wanted, let me take a different view. This will be better, I think. Okay. So this is what another one. Okay. So percentage of sales done by category, okay, and subcategories. How much percentage they have done? And label it. So where I come to know, when I click on the label, 11%, 11%. So 11.88 and 11.66, so 60, 3.55, sorry, 3.0, 5.9, 7.9. So this is how, where we can create a data for what? So we create a sum of data and continue. Question of that is what? You have done what? Show the percentage of?
Show the percentage of data by category and subcategory.
Based on sales. Yeah, data by category and subcategory. Subcategory. Based on sales, right?
Yes, sir.
Based on sales. So clear until here, whatever you have done. So still table calculations means not yet ended. Still we have depth about more about this. Okay. So until here it is clear how to take percentage of that.
Yes, sir.
Clear.
Yes, sir.
So next class, just the continuity of this, we will be doing. Okay, so second concept, we will be doing like a running total. You know what is running total? You know what is running total? Anyone have any idea about what is running total?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me, ma'am.
I had a network issue and I left the class after analyze. You told analyze, sir. What is after that?
Which one? Okay, analyze. Okay, totals. So you can take show total, grand totals like that. Okay, that I will again come. Okay, for that thing, we can't take that one. Okay, we'll do it in a different big data. At that time, we require that. What is the total column and above, bigger top row, header row, everything we require. So like this one, I will, let me show you, see like this. Like this. Can you see this now? What is the grand total of that?
Yes, sir.
Before that, we have done like this. I'm taking that. So what is the grand total of that? Just click on the analyze, go for totals. What is the grand total of that? On the top, on the bottoms, like this. So these things and all can be done. Okay, so that we will do deeply with a big data. Okay, that's not a problem. This is what we can do with you. Column grand totals, all these columns. So now, I was asking something like, what is running total? Anyone? Just have any
sir,
idea
for
about
that? For example, we are given the data set as A, B, C, D. Then running total for the first one will be A, and then for the second one it will be A plus B. Then for the third one it will be A plus B plus C. So this is the running total, sir.
Super. So that is nothing but called as running calculations. Anyone understood that what she has told?
Yes, sir.
Clear. So if everyone understood, means I think I should not open the Excel at all. Even I'll tell you this. Here I have 5, 7, and 13. So running total means that side first comes 5. And here, total of these two comes as how much? 12. And 12. Total of these three comes here, how much?
25.
So this is nothing but called as running total. The first one becomes the same thing. And the second one comes the sum of these two. And third one, sum of these three becomes the total. So running called as running total. Or we can say like this, this one, and this for total of this one. And total of all these three, one, this one. This like this, and this like this, and this like this. We can add arrow mark also like this. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Lighting something,
yes,
arrow.
Sir.
Yeah. Okay. Trying to see some arrows. It's not there. So this is running total. We are going to see how to do practically inside that data set where we required running data. Okay, running total means running total. And next, we are going to see another something like analyze tools, how to take that grand total, how to take grand rows or top to place, bottom to place, left, right, subtotals, all totals, everything we are going to see about this analyze. All these things. Totals, subtotals, analyze, everything we are going to see. Okay, when we will get that all subtotals, Okay, why? Because it is hidden now. When I will get, when I have subcategory, I will get subtotals also. So like this, everything will be doing that in our next session. Okay. This setup. So is that clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
So this is what I'll just explain you in this next class deeply, this one. So as of now, today's concept, everything are clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what and all, I think we have done many workouts today, right? What and all we have done? Once again, repeat that.
So we first did data blending.
Okay.
Then we learn how to change the primary and secondary data sets.
Okay.
Then we learn how to make the common field in the data blending.
Yes.
Then we learn how to find the sum of profit based on yearly data. Then how to find the sum of sales based on region, and then we did some hierarchy, then we knew how to make the folder and how to do the table calculation, and then finally we did how to like what is this running table,
running total. Just we have talked about running total. Okay. So deep about running total and another concepts about that analysis tapes and all, we will be continuing in our next session. Okay. So I hope everyone are understood of our today's concept. So what you have to do is just you have to do it everything whatever we have done in order and attach in the assignment and send, including that one more assignment I'm giving. Just you have to try and you show me the data how you are getting. Take the first question. Taken?
Yes.
So that one, you try it as an assignment, including that one. Clear? So I'll give a small key for that. So where you will get the options in this place. So whatever you have to do, another options will be getting in this place. Okay. So first you try it. If you're not getting, the same thing I'll try. I'm going to show you in the next class. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So I can clear the calculations now. Okay. So remaining things and all, we will do in our next session. Okay. So bye. I think 5 minutes extra. Already some of you have left. Okay. So bye ma. So practice everything and send the assignments. What and all we have done, data blending, this drill down hierarchy, sales based on timelines, everything and table calculations until that running total. Do that everything and send me that practical files. and including that what I sent the last one also.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.